Well, my first mission was Gemini 8 with Neil Armstrong, and we performed the first docking in space. And then I flew on Apollo 9 with Jim McDivitt and Rusty Schweikert, which was an Earth orbit test of all the lunar hardware and software. And then Apollo 15 was first, as NASA called it, extended scientific exploration of the moon.
More than 300 red line values, watching temperatures and pressures to ensure they do not go above nominal. In the case that it did, any one of these key people could call in to hold the countdown. 1 minute and 36 seconds and counting, still going well. The pressurization sequence is still continuing in the vehicle. We're now 90 seconds away from liftoff, all still going well. We're going internal power with the vehicle at the 50-second mark.
Then they took us down and they put us in the van, and they drove us very slowly to the launch pad. As we drove out, it was very slow. Very quiet. No one was saying anything. I was surprised because we made that drive several times before. It was always a lot of light conversation. That morning, a lot of words were said.
Mark, T-minus 50 seconds and counting on Apollo 15. The astronaut control and launch vehicle and spacecraft components all go as our countdown proceeds. Now 50 seconds, we have the most power transfer. The vehicle now on the battery power in the vehicle, and all is still going well. Minimize the power signal and making some final checks. Now charging the 40-second mark.
Apollo 15 was quite different from anything that had flown before. We carried, as an example, for the first time, the Lunar Rover. We also carried a scientific instrument module into lunar orbit.
Translunar Injection, TLI. Now they turned around to dock with the lunar module and pull it free of the now useless booster.
Centering on the picture is good now, and we're getting an excellent quality picture.
Very good. We're almost there. Capture.
Legend.
Retracting.
Roger.
Hard dock, Houston.
Roger.
Their determination, if they make no change in their plan, and this simulation shows that engine burning. It should be taking place right at this moment. It burns for 5 minutes and 54 seconds, almost 6 minutes, slows down the spacecraft by nearly 2,000 miles an hour, from 5,700 miles an hour to 3,720 miles an hour. And as Leo just pointed out, we have before, that is the orbital speed that suspends it between the moon's gravitational pull and the momentum which would throw it on out into space again with this speed.
Hello, Houston. The Endeavour is on station with cargo, and what a fantastic sight. Oh, this is really profound. I'll tell you, this is absolutely mind-boggling up here.
Gentlemen, I can well imagine that a foreign planet must be a weird thing to see.
-3.
pointers look good. 43. 33. 25. 2. 7% fuel. 20 at 1. 15 at 1. Minus 1. Minus 1. 6% fuel. 10 feet minus 1. 8 feet minus 1. Contact. Man. Okay, you student of Falcon is on the plane at Hadley.
Roger, roger, Falcon.
Dave, an extraordinary television picture here.
Okay, Houston, as I stand out here in the wonders of the unknown at Hadley, I sort of realize there's a fundamental truth to our nature. Man must explore. And this is exploration at its greatest. And Jim, I'm going to put a big circle around this glass ball so we don't mess it up. It's pretty neat.
But you want me to take it as a contingency sample?
We ought to document it. We won't lose it. But that front pad is really loose, isn't it? Yeah.
Okay, why don't you get my antenna?
Get your visor, Jim. Let me get your antenna. Looks like you're going to have to do the bulk of the work today. What? Atta, keep it taut. Atta boy. Okay, we're coming up here, 45. Up to about, easy, Jim, easy. Okay. Here, let me help you. You're gonna feel it. Looks like she's coming down okay.
Right on.
Hopefully I lost my balance.
Spectacular demonstration.
Right there by the rock.
Yeah.
See the rock hole?
Yeah.
Is that a glass one right, sitting right below it?
Yeah, it sure looks like it.
It was under it, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Hunter, we'll stand by for a verbal description in fact. Any sign of layering?
No signs of layering. I do find some small fragments, white fragments, black fragments. I just exposed a very small fragment, about 3 millimeters, of a black glass. Yeah, I can even see the Earth. You know, another problem is the Earth is getting smaller.
Roger, Dave. That's one of Kepler's mission rules. You might try cycling that camera without a mag in it, if we've caught you in time here.
Yeah, you have. Just right. Okay, I'm trying it. Yeah, I think the camera's working, Joe. I'm going to put a Romeo on it.
Sounds good.
That thing worked for a while this morning, didn't it, Jim?
Yeah. And I have the 500 out.
And look at that reel.
How about that?
How about that, geology fan?
From the top of the reel down, there's debris all the way. And it looks like some outcrops directly at about 11 o'clock to the sun line. It looks like a layer, about 5% of the real wall with a vertical base on it. And within the vertical base, I can see other small lineations, horizontal, about maybe 10% of that unit. Yeah, it is going back up. Yeah, no problem coming back up. He's back down. Oh, you looked at that big one there that has the,
Yeah, I took some close-ups of that.
Boy, that's a beauty.
You should see the vesicles in that, and the alignment, the orientation of the vesicle.
Called organization, huh?
Yep. Want me to come down, Dave?
Nope. Got a good one.
I guess so. Jim, that's a firm, but we want you to break down the core stem first, please. That is separated.
Of course, the crew will break down. Stem never will. Okay, I got a pan of the rover. Yeah, that stem there. Jim, they keep going the way you're going. Yeah, don't bother with the treadle yet, Mr. Oh, shoot, the tool isn't in there. It must be in your seat. You didn't see the tool out there?
No, all I saw was UHT.
Must be in your seat then.
Jim, we copied both solar wind and penetrometer drum in the ETB.
Not quite yet. I haven't put the solar wind in yet, but I will shortly. I want to watch this.
Joe, okay. You have a good picture there. I've got the...
Beautiful picture, Dave.
Well, in my left hand, I have a feather. In my right hand, a hammer. And I guess one of the reasons we got here today was because of a gentleman named Galileo a long time ago who made a rather significant discovery about falling objects in gravity fields. And we thought that where would be a better place to confirm his findings than on the moon. And so we thought we'd try it here for you. The feather happens to be appropriately a falcon feather for our falcon. And I'll drop the two of them here and hopefully they'll hit the ground at the same time. How about that?
Which
proves that Mr. Galileo was correct in his findings. Fourth stage, engine arm bath in. 99 Pro. Good liftoff, automatic.
Hello, Endeavour. This is Yankee Clipper. Over.
Hello, Yankee Clipper. How are you?
Roger, I got a naval tradition to pass on to you.
Go ahead.
Roger, when ships of the line have completed a mission such as yours and they return to home port, they always have a broom flying from the yardarm. Over.
Fudge, well, we'll do that.
Thank you.
Turned over.
One main shoot appears to be